हेलो एवरीवन, सो दिस इज़ द लास्ट चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 14 ऑफ यूनिट नंबर 6 एंड द लास्ट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सिलेबस, दैट इज़ द सिस्टम डिपेंडेबिलिटी. सो द सिस्टम डिपेंडेबिलिटी इज़ फॉर मेनी सॉफ्टवेयर इंटेंसिव सिस्टम, द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट सिस्टम प्रॉपर्टी इज़ द डिपेंडेबिलिटी ऑफ द सिस्टम, दैट इज ऑन वॉट योर सिस्टम इज़ डिपेंडेबल. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द सिस्टम इज़ डिपेंडेंट ऑन, फर्स्ट इनपुट इज़ द बजट. It is the dependability, the budget, the memory you are going to use, and again what type of a softwares are required, what is the dependency, that is the customer is again your dependency part. The dependability of the system reflects the extent of a user confidence and that it will operate as a user expect, all that they it will not corrupt data or other system and will not fail in the normal use. That is, suppose you design the system for the Windows system, then it should need to be performed all the operation on your Linux, on your Android mobile phone. So this is the dependability of your system. User trusts a system that is dependable. Now next one is importance of dependability. What is the importance of dependability? Why you should need to check the dependability on your system? A system failure may have widespread effects with a large number of people affected by the failure. Systems that are not dependable and are reliable, unsafe or insecure may be rejected by their users. The cost of system failure may be very high if the failure leads to economic losses or physical damage. If you not check what is the cost of the failure of your system on your Android phone, so in no one can use your system because they will consider your system is a damaged system and it is made for only a specific platform. So this is not the criteria for developing any software. Whenever you develop any software, that should need to be used on all the platforms. So for that you should need to check the dependability of your system. So independable system may cause information loss with a high consequent recovery cost. Next, the dependability basically consists of availability, reliability, safety and security. So availability is your system should need to be available any time. Reliability is it should need to be operate on, that is if 100 people are operating on 1 minute, then within next 2 minutes your 100 people should need to access your data. That is a reliability that you should need to achieve. The availability, that is your system needs should be provided for the time mentioned by the customer, that is if the ATM machine, then it should need to operate for 24/7. The reliability is if 5 minutes are required for the one person for executing his transaction, then for all 24 minutes there should need to be access of 24 multiplied by 5 customers so that they can operate their data. And safety, that is whatever transaction you are going to provide, they should need to be safe. And security is the ability of a system to protect itself against accidental, or that is if the cash is sometime not available or it get finished before withdrawal, then the message should need to be displayed. Now next one is the principal properties of the availability. The probability that the system will be up and running and able to deliver useful services to the user. Reliability is the probability that the system will correctly deliver services as expected by the user. Safety is a judgment of how likely it is that the system will not damage people or the system's environment. Security is a judgment of how likely it is that the system can resist accidentally or deliberate attacks and instructions. Next is dependability attributes. Dependencies are safe system operations depend on the system being available and operating reliably. A system may be unreliable because its data has been corrupted by an external attack. The denial of service attacks on a system are intended to make it invaluable. That is, I told the example of the amount or the cash on your ATM machine is finished during your transaction. So these type of attacks should need to be handled. This type of query should need to be handled by your system. If a system is infected with a virus, you cannot be confident in its reliability or the safety. So you should need to provide and all these attribute your recovery in your system. Next one is the dependability is subjective. The dependability of a system is not absolute but depends on the judgment and expectation of a system stakeholders. So the system dependability is not absolute, but whenever your stakeholders are going to judgment your system, it will check the expectations versus executions. That is, what type of expectation the user should have with your system, all the expectations should need to be executed by your system itself. What seems to be a system failure to one stakeholder in normal behavior to another. Next one is a user expectations. A banking system does not update user accounts in real time but queue the transaction and updates accounts twice a day. So this is the expectation of a user. A user that expects real time updates may consider these undependable as they cannot be sure whether or not the account balance is accurate. User trusts a system if they think it is dependable and it is based on previous experience. Some people trust a system so don't do backups. Other is backup obviously. Next is dependability and specification. Dependability can only be defined formally by relating behavior to the system specification. A failure can be thought of as a deviation from a specification. However, many specifications do not reflect the real requirements of the system users. A system that conforms to its specification may fail from the perspective of some users. Next one is, furthermore, users don't read specifications so don't know how the system is supposed to behave. That is, you should need to provide the manual for your user. Still, they will not check the correct manual and they use the system and they they consider that the system can perform n number of tasks. Therefore, a formal definition of dependability may not reflect user experience with the system. N number of users and n number of expectations. So, you cannot create the system which can meet all the needs of the customer. So, better is take one particular aim for your system and develop the system which can meet the needs of the particular customer. So this is overall your software engineering. Here we studied the different type of concepts such as how you are going to build your software, your SRS model, how you are going to design your software. The first one is how you are going to plan for your software, your designing, how you are going to model your software. Then it's coding, and the last phase is the testing. Thank you.